Previous recording, we discussed about the linked list, single linked list. Today we are going to discuss about the circular linked list. Circular linked list is, we can represent it like this. It is the start. As you see, this is the single linked list in which there is a start pointer which is pointing to the first node, and the last node, the next part of the last node is pointing to the null. Means it does not have any further node further, so it is pointing to the null. Now in the circular linked list, the last node of the linked list is pointing to a first node of the linked list. So that's why it is called a circular linked list. So that only the difference between the single linked list and circular linked list is that in the single linked list, the last node is having the null value at the last next part of the last node. But in case of the circular linked list, the next part of the last node is again pointing to the first node of the linked list. So what's the benefit over here of the circular linked list in compared to the single linked list is that if you are at any node in the single linked list, suppose we are at this node and we have to go at the previous node in the single linked list, then we cannot go directly with the previous node. In that case, we have to start again from the first node of the linked list and then only we can go over here. But in the case of the circular linked list, if you are at any node and if you want to go at the previous node, then we have to traverse. Suppose if we are at this node and we want to come at this node. So by the help of this circular linked list, we can come again back to the previous node. So the traversing become easier in the circular linked list in compared to the single linked list. So here it does not have any null value. The last part, the next part of the last node is pointing to the first node. Now how will say that it is the end of the list? End of the list will be said that where we will get the next part of any node is containing the address of the start node. If the next part of the any node is containing address of the starting node, so we can say that this next part is the last node of the linked list. So by that we can find that it is the end of the separate linked list. Now here the operation that we can perform in the separate linked list is that, let's say, first we will talk about the insert operation. The insertion that we are doing at the beginning or at the top of the circular linked list. So means we want to add a new node over here at the top of the circular linked list. So that can be written like this, the algorithm can be written like this, as we have seen in the previous lecture, that if the first part, if aware is equals to null, then we'll say right overflow. Means no memory is there, then we'll say that we cannot create and we'll go to the step number and we'll terminate the program. Otherwise, we'll say the new node is equals to aware, we will get to memory and create a new node. Then we will move the aware to the next available free memory location. So aware equals to aware of next free location, the aware pointer will move and we will create a new node. So this new node is created. In the new node, at the data part, we'll store a value. So here we'll get the value. Let's say that I have to store a value 9 over here. 9 I will assign, so new node of data will be the value. Then here, as we have to insert this node at the top of the list, so we have to adjust the pointer of the last node also. So for adjusting the pointer of the last node, we require the one pointer will start moving from the top of the list up to the end of the list, because we have to adjust the pointer of the last node. So we require one pointer at the last node also. So let's say that we have taken the pointer ptr. Then we will say ptr equals to start. So we create one pointer ptr here. That will point again to the start of the node. Then we will move the pointer ptr up to the last node. So we will say while ptr of next is not equals to start. The same one I told you, that how we say that it is the end of the list, wherever we find the start pointer, the value of the start pointer in the next part of any node, that will indicate the end of the linked list. So we will say ptr of next is not equal to start. Up to date, we will say ptr is equals to ptr of next. We will move the pointer. So by this, the ptr pointer will keep on moving and it will come over here, ptr, and it is pointing to this, the last node. Then the seventh step, at the new node of next, we have already stored the data part. Now in the next part, what will store? In the new node of next part, we will store the address of the first node. So the address of the first node is available in the start. So new node of the next, now it is pointing to this first node. New node of next is the start. Now we have to address the pointer of the last node, so that will point to this one. So we will say ptr of next will be new node. So now the pointer that is which was initially pointing to the start, now it will point to this one. So the last node is pointing to this node is now pointing to this one. Now this node will become the first node of the list. So the next step will be the ninth step. We will say that now the start will be a new node. So now the start which is pointing to this, now will point to this one. And the tenth, we are saying the exit. So this is the step 10. So this way we can insert a new node at the beginning of the circular linked list. Next we will discuss about that, how you insert a new node at the end of a circular linked list. Let's say again modify this. Let's say this is pointing to this, the start is pointing to this, and now we have to add a new node over here at the end of a separate list. So up to here it is the same. Modify the step number for the new node is away. We created a new node, then away is pointed to the next node, and new node of data part is the away. Then the ptr we have taken here. While ptr of next is not equal to start, ptr will be the ptr of next. Now here we need to modify the some steps. Then we will see. We will set the data part of the new node. So let's say data part I have stored here, 9. Now this next part of the new node, this we are saying is a new node. The next part of the new node is it is inserting at the end of the linked list. So then next part will point to the start. So new node of next will point to the start. So this pointer will get modified. So new node. node of next is pointing to the start. Now the PTI is pointing to the last node, so PTR of next, PTR of next will have the address of new node. And then the 9 is exit. So here register number 9. So PTR of next is now pointing to this node. So this way we adjusted the pointer and added the new node at the end of a separate request. So this is the algorithm. Now the next we will discuss about deletion of a node from the separate request. So first we will talk about the deletion from the beginning. Now whenever we have to perform the deletion, first thing we have to check that whether our list is empty or not. So we will say if start is equals to null, then if there is no node within the list, then we cannot perform any deletion. So in that case, we will say write underscore. Go to step, we'll add the step number there. Now in this, when we have to delete a first node from the beginning, so we require another pointer PTR, because the next part of the PTR will get adjusted over here. So we have taken the one pointer PTR, that is this start. We will move the PTR pointer up to the end of the separate request. So while PTR of next is not equals to the start, we will move the pointer. So PTR will be equals to PTR of next. We will move the PTR pointer, so now it is pointing to the last node, and then we will adjust the pointer so that this node is deleted from here. We will say PTR of next. In the next part of the PTR, at present it is containing the address of the start. Now after modification, the next part of the PTR will have the address of the next node of the start. So we will say PTR of next will have the address of this node. Address of this node is available in the next part of the start. So we will say start of next. So PTR of next is now set at the start of next. Means it is pointing to this node. Then we will say this node will be deleted. So free start, this node is deleted from here, and then we will take the pointer to the next one. So the sixth one is the start, where the start will point? The start will point to the PTR of next. PTR of next is this node, so the start will point to this node. So we adjusted the pointer, then it is the exit. So here step number 7. So this way we can perform the deletion from a circular. So after the modification, the start will came from here to here. By this we can perform the deletion of the first node from the circular request. Next we have to discuss about the deletion of a node from the end of a separate request. This is circular interest. We have to delete in last note. So again, we perform the same thing. We will check for the empty underflow. If it is, there is no node, then we perform the underflow and we will exit the program. Otherwise, we will take the one pointer ptr which is pointing to the start. We will move the pointer ptr. So while the ptr of next is not equal to start, we will move the pointer ptr. Now we are deleting this node. So this node will get deleted, but we require a accessing to this previous node also, so that we can adjust the next pointer of this previous node to the start. So we require one pointer at the ptr that we have to delete. We require one pointer to its previous node, which next pointer we have to adjust to the start. So we require one pointer here that will say SFP ptr. So the algorithm can be written like this, that while the ptr of next is not equal to start, means the end of the circular interest, will say pre-ptr is equals to ptr. Initially both the ptr and pre-ptr is pointing at the start, so we will move. So pre-ptr equals to ptr and ptr is equals to ptr of next. So both the pre-ptr and ptr are pointing to the alternative nodes, right? Now when they reach at this position, pre-ptr is pointing to the previous node and ptr is pointing to the last node. So at that time, we will say the fourth step we can write here, that pre-ptr of next, the next part of the pre-ptr, this will point to the start. So it will have the address of the start. So now this pointer, which is initially pointing to the ptr, is now pointing to this one. Now pointing to this one. Okay. Then that node is free from the circular interest. So we will say free ptr. And then 6 is exit. So this way we can delete a node from the end of the circular interest. This is the algorithm for this. Next, we are going to discuss about doublet interest. In the doublet interest, we are having a pointer at both sides, at the previous and to the next node. The structure of this node can be written like this. Means actually there are three parts in the single interest. We have seen that a node consists of the only two parts, but in the case of the double interest, a node consists of the three parts. This is called a data part. This is called a pointing to the previous node. This is called a pointing to the next node. So the representation of the double interest is like this. It is the start. The representation is like this. Let's say the values are stored 5, 10, 7, 3. So in this, every node is pointing to the next node and next node is pointing to the previous node. So this is the previous part, this is the next part. So next part of this node is pointing to the this node, and previous part of this node is pointing to this node. In the same way. And it is the last node and it is the first node. So previous part of the first node is pointing to the null, and the next pointer of the last node is pointing to the null. There does not have any other pointer over there. So the previous and the next part of the first and the last node are the null. Now the benefit of the double linked list or the single linked list is that in the single linked list we can move, traverse only in the one direction, only in the forward direction. If you have to move to the towards the backward, that is not possible in the single linked list. So if you have to access just previous node, then again you have to start from the first node, right? But in this other double linked list, if you are at some node and you want to go at just previous node, let's say that for example if you are at this node and you want to access this node, so we can traverse backward also. But in this of the single linked list, we have to traverse again the complete list. So it is the way the time consuming approach in the single linked list. But the accessing of a node in the double linked list is quite easy, quite fast. As well as the searching of any node within the double linked list is quite fast, because we does not need to reverse the whole list again. We can just move backwards or the forward in both the ways. So both the ways are possible over here. So this is the way the double linked lists are represented. Let's look at the some of the algorithms or some of the operation that we can perform over the double linked list. The operations that we can perform over here. First, we are going to discuss about insert at beginning. Before that, let's tell you the structure that is used to represent this node in the programming language. It can be written like this: struct node, struct node pointer previous. It is a structure type. The previous is the pointer which is pointing to the node of the same type, right? Then integer data. Then it is said struct node pointer next. So it is a previous pointer, this one, it is the next pointer, this one, and this is the data part. So these are the three parts are there. So these are the three parts of the node. So it is written like this in the programming part. So we can define the node like this. Now let's look at the algorithm for inserting a node at the beginning of a linked list. So again, initially the first step, if away is equals to null, then write overflow. Go to state, write the set number. Otherwise, if the space is available, so we will create a new node. New node is equals to avail is equals to avail of next. Fourth, so we have created a new node here. This is the new node is created. Now in this new node of the data is equal to value. Let's say I am inserting value 9. So this data part I have said over here. Now next one. The previous part of the new node will obviously point to the null because we are inserting at the beginning. So new node of the previous will be null. This part is set as a null. Okay. Then we have to adjust the pointer of both of these and start to be adjusted. So now the previous part of this node will point to the new node, next part of the new node will point to this one, and the start will point to this one. So this pointer will need to adjust. So it is written like this: PTR new node of next, the next part of the new node, it will point to the start. So new node of next is the start. Then this previous part of the start, so the start of previous, this previous part of the start, that will point to this new node. So start of previous will have the value new node. So now it is pointing to this, this is pointing to this, and then we have to adjust this start. So start will have a value of new node, and then 9 is exit. So this way we can insert a new node at the beginning of a double request. Now let's say insert at the end. So we have to insert the node at the end, right? So this part is removed, this part is removed. To here, all things are same. Let's say remove this step. So we have created a new node, new node data is set and all this thing, and we have set the value over here. So this new node is created, up to this, all the things are almost same. Now come to the next part. Now where we have added the new node at the end of this, so the next part of the new node will point to the left. So new node up next will be null. New node of next is null, then 6-1. Now we have to add this new node at the last, so we have to adjust the pointer of this to this. So there we require a pointer through which we can access the particular node. So we will say ptr is equals to start. Ptr is pointing initially to this, then while ptr of next is not equals to null. So it is the next part of the null. So we remove the ptr to the at that position. So we will say ptr is equals to ptr of next. So we remove the pointer ptr to that. So ptr will come over there. So ptr is here. It is pointing to this. Now we adjust the pointer. Now ptr of next, the next part of this will have the address of the new node. So ptr of next is equals to new node. Here it will point to this. Then 9th new node of previous is pointing to the ptr. This is pointing to this. Node of previous is pointing to the ptr. And then 10th is exit. So this way we can perform the insertion of a new node at the end of a double request. Now next we are going to discuss that insert after given node. So here we are going to discuss about that inserting of a node after the given node. Let's say that I want to insert a new node after 10. Here, after 10. So initially, first I will create a new node. So this is the steps. I have created new node and I have assigned the data value over here. So let's assign the data value 9 over here. Right? Then we require our own pointer ptr, so which will move to the within the linked list. So we will move the pointer over here. So ptr is initially at the start. We will move the ptr up to the term at this node. And so we will say that ptr I want to insert after the given node. So we have to come up to the 10, because 10, after the 10 we have to insert. So ptr next is not equals to none. So we will move the ptr. Ptr is pointing this node. So, ptr equals to ptr options. So, that node is there. Now, we have to adjust the pointer. Now, in the new node of previous is having the address of ptr. The new node of previous is having the address of ptr. New node of next will have the address of this node. So this node is accessed by ptr of next. This is the ptr of next. This address of this node is available in this, the next part of the ptr. So we can access that thing. So now this is pointing to this one, this node. Okay. Now the next part and the previous part, both of this we have to modify. So we can modify like this. Let's say that ptr of next of previous. This part we have to access. In this part we need the address of this node, new node. So we can access like this, that ptr of next means this node. Of previous, this part ptr of next of previous. So ptr of next of previous will have the address of new node. So now which is pointing to this one, now it is pointing to this one, and then we need to address at this location also. So we can say that ptr of next will be so which is pointing to this, now pointing to this, and then 11 is exit. So we are here. So this way we can insert any node after the given node. Next is insert before given node. Let's say this is the initial state, and we have to insert a new node again here, but before 7. Initially, we said that we want to insert a new node after 10. Now we are saying we want to insert a new node before 7. So, before the given node. So, let's look at the algorithm. First, we create a new node. New node is created. New node of data part. We set the value. So, let's say the value is assigned over here, 9. Then we take the pointer ptr. Ptr will point to this. While the ptr of next is not equal to now, so we will move the pointer ptr up to here at the 7. So ptr is pointing to this. Right? So we move the pointer ptr. Before, in the previous algorithm, we move the pointer up to here. Now we will move the pointer up to here. Up to this. So ptr equals this. Now we have to adjust the pointer. Let's say again, now we adjust the pointer. So new node of next will have the address of the PTR. New node of next will have the address of PTR. Then new node of previous, new node of previous, it will have the address of this node, and address of this node is available in the previous part of the PTR. So PTR previous. Now it is pointing to this one. So we adjust both the pointer of the new node and the data part. Okay, now we have to adjust the next part of this and the previous part of this. Now PTR of previous of next. PTR of previous. Previous means this one. Of next. Next is this one. At this part we require the address of new node. So it is equals to new node. PTR of previous of next is new node. Then next one. So this is pointing to this new node. Now in this previous part we require the address of this node. So PTR of previous will be new. So now it is pointing to this one. And then 11 is exit. So this way we can insert a node before the given node. Next, we will discuss about deletion. Deletion of a node from the deprecated list. So, deletion, first we will discuss the deletion of a node from the beginning. So deletion of the node from the beginning. So again, first we have to check if the start is equals to null. If the linked list is empty, then we cannot perform the deletion. So first we'll check the empty linked list. If the start is null, then write underflow go to state with this set. Now when we are deleting this one, we'll say we'll take the one pointer PTR is equals to start third, start is equals to start of next. So we have taken one point of PTR, PTR is pointing to this. You move the start, so the start is pointing to this. Okay, now we will say the start of previous is set as a null. So start of previous is set as a null. And then fifth you will say free PTR. So we will delete the node. So by this we can delete a node from the start of the list. Okay. Now let's say delete a node from the end of a WN list. Let's say we will delete the last node of the WN list. So in this case, we require one pointer PTR that will move up to the end of a WN list. So we will take the one pointer over here. Then while PTR of next is not equals to null, PTR is equals to PTR of next. So we'll move the pointer PTR to the last location. Then we'll say PTR of previous of next. PTR of previous of next, this part will be set as null. So here this part is set as null. Then we will say free PTR. And then 6 is exit. So by this we can delete a node from the end of the WN list. Okay. Now next we will discuss the delete after QN node. Okay, in this, let's say I want to delete a node after 10, means the 7th one. I want to delete this node, so I am giving after the given node, so I am giving the value 10, and whatever node is there, that will be deleted. So as I said, again test for the empty, take the pointer PTR, which is at the top of the list, then move the pointer PTR up to PTR of data. Is not equals to none. So we'll test the value data part and we'll check that up to it is not equals to none, we'll move the pointer PTR. So now PTR come at this point. Then we'll say we will delete this node. So let's say we'll take the 10 is equals to PTR of next. This is PTR, which is pointing to this. We take the another pointer variable 10, which is pointing to the PTR of this. PTR of this is this one. So let's say the 10 is pointing to this. 10 is here. Okay. Now we have to adjust the pointer of both of these one. So we'll say PTR of next. In the PTR of next, we will have the address of this node. So where the address of this node is available? In the 10 of next. So now this is pointing to this one. PTR of next is pointing to the 10 of next. Okay. 6. 10 of next. Okay, now this is this one. a previous is pointing to the PDR. Now it is pointing to this one, right? And then 7 is free tempo. 8, that's it. So by this we are able to delete a node after the new node from the domain.